Clark, for whatever reason, and in common with a famous television detective, had always kept it a closely guarded secret. And in spite of her frequent invitations to do so when they'd first worked together, Focal certainly could not bring himself to call her Nobby. "Right, Focal," Clark continued, after only the briefest of pauses. "Something's just landed on my desk, which I thought you might be interested in." Focal knew she would not have called for chat. They didn't have that sort of relationship, and that she would cut to the chase straight away. The DS was not one for small talk. Unless she got on the scotch, of course, then she could be quite garrulous. "There's a connection with a case in your patch," Clark continued. "Are you involved in the Melanie Cook murder at all?" Focal felt his pulse quicken. "I'm Deputy SIO," he said. Then he corrected himself. "Or I was. It's done and dusted now, boss. DNA match with a father is being charged. We announced it yesterday." "I know," replied Clark. "But I'm afraid I may be about to rock your boat, Focal." "I'm hanging on to the sides," said the DI. "We've been looking into the suspicious death of a male teenager found in a Soho hotel a month ago," Clark continued. "He died of strangulation, that much was abundantly clear from the start. We don't know yet, though, whether his death was murder or an accident. Have you heard of asphyxiophilia?"
"I don't just do crosswords, I compile them, boss," replied Focal.
"Yeah." Clark knew that well enough. She sounded totally unimpressed. "Not a term that fits naturally into the crossword section of our own dear Daily Telegraph, Focal."
"I also read the news pages, boss. Fits in there. It's a deliberate partial strangulation, using a cord or often a belt, tightened around the neck. It reduces the amount of oxygen to the brain during sexual stimulation, heightening the pleasure of orgasm. Dangerous old game."